Welcome to Power BI Data Modeling and Visualization Tutorial. Today, we will create a data model from an MS Excel-based dataset. And then, we will create a dashboard using that data model. So, let's start our tutorial. Our dataset contains sales, product category, store, staff, marketing channel, payment method, list of all customers, and brand information. Connect to the data set using the Microsoft Excel button. Wait for the Power BI to connect to the Excel file. In the Navigator window, select all the tables and press Load. Wait for the Power BI to end processing. Depending on the size of data, this may take some time. Once the dataset is connected and loaded into the Power BI, all the tables and their fields will be available in the data pane at the right side, which can be used for visualization. Now, let's go to the model view and create a data model. Data modeling in Power BI means that we will connect all of these tables together using their ID columns. This will allow us to use fields from multiple tables in a single visual. Let's start with the sales table, which has the most ID fields. Connect the sales table to the channel table using the channel ID. Connect the sales table to the customer table. Then to the method table, using the method ID. To the product table, using the product ID. To the staff table, using the staff ID. To the store table, using the store ID. Connect the product table to the category table using the category ID. And to brand table using the brand ID. Look for any other relationship that could be made. Looks like we have made all the connections. Now we can go back to the report view and create some visuals. But first, we will go to the table view. And, in the sales table, we will create a new column named sales. Sales will be the number of units or quantity, multiplied by the price of the product. We will use the related function to bring the price of the product from product table. Inside the related function, we will select the price field from the product column. Now we have sales revenue in our sales table. However, we still need to create another column. In this column, we will calculate the net sales. By deducting the discount allowed on sales from the sales revenue. The amount of discount equals the amount of sales multiplied by the discount percentage. Now we will get the actual sales revenue after discounts. Let's format this column in proper currency format by clicking the comma button. Now, go to the report view and create a title for your dashboard, using the text box visual. The date is not in proper format. Go back to the table view and change its data type to proper date format. Go to the report view and add a line and column chart. Place the chart at the bottom left side of the report. Add the date field to the x-axis. The net sales to the column y-axis. And quantity field to the line y-axis of the line and column chart. If dates don't work properly, remove the date field and add it again. Remove the day and quarter from date hierarchy. Add a bar chart and place it next to the existing chart. Add the net sales field to the x-axis. Add the name field from staff table to the y-axis. Create a copy of this chart and place it at the bottom right corner. Replace the staff name field with the store name field. Now we have both staff and the store performance in our report. Add a pie chart or a donut chart to your dashboard. Add the brand field to the legend area. And the net sales field to the values area. Place the chart at the top right corner of your dashboard. Make a copy of this chart and place it next to the existing chart. Replace the brand column with the category column. Create another copy of the donut chart. Replace the category column with the channel column. Create another copy of the chart. Replace the channel field with the method field from the method table. Now we have sales by brand, product category, marketing channel, and payment method. Our dashboard is now complete. This is how we perform data modeling in Power BI, and then use those models in visualizations. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more tutorials and updates.